Hey guys, Benham here again. Today we've got a whole box of premium gold Return of the Bling in first edition, which is a pretty awesome box to open. You've probably seen my video a little while back, not too long ago. I opened two little mini boxes. Well, this contains five of those mini boxes. So this is to celebrate the first month of activity from this channel. Happy to be here. It's not that much, I mean 1 month, but still it's worth celebrating. So that's why I got a full box of these. It's an awesome set. It's got awesome stuff in it. It's pretty collectible, more than valuable, but still it's pretty cool. It's first edition, and I paid for it by selling a few cards. So didn't cost me much, and it's gonna be an awesome video for you guys. And for our interesting cards, we've got these standard size, so they're not custom fit for actual Yu-Gi-Oh cards, but they are pretty cool. These awesome Warhammer 40K Imperial Guard sleeves. I think that's a sergeant, whatever. And since there are interesting cards in this set, like Raigeki and Solemn Warning, I believe, I decided to get four of my awesome standard size sleeves. Grumpy cats. Because, well, I love wolves. It's a funny meme sleeve. And we don't need too many of them, so I didn't have to unsleeve too many cards. I will open this on camera, but for those of you who don't want to wait until it has been opened, you can just skip ahead maybe a minute or two. I'm going to open the whole set, the whole mini boxes, everything, and put all the packs aside. That way, if you want to skip, because it's long, it is not even a problem. I understand very well how you feel. But man, just look at this. Awesome. This is going to be one fun video. Damn. Okay. Sorry about that. This one fell behind the desk. So proceeding with opening him first, because that little bastard tried to run away from us. Okay, 15 gold packs. Okay, so from the last one, the last box that was in the bigger box, to the first box that was in front of the others in the box that contained all these packs. So let's dig in. We are looking for Raigeki for other staples of the sort. We are looking for formulas, synchron, something like that. We're looking for anything interesting, really. The Exodia pieces are not a bad thing to get either. Last time I got three heads and one of the legs, so we could try to get the rest, right? So we are starting off with Absolute King Backjack. Masked Hero Anki, Gale, Trapshix, and ooh, nice. Charge of the Light Brigade. That is worth a sleeve. Yep, it's a pretty good card to get in this set. It's not that hard to get as it's not one of the secrets, but it's still a pretty good card. Anki is nice, but since we got one in the last vid, not going to sleeve uselessly. Let's keep going. Oh, nice. Rose Lover. Don't need her, but still a pretty cool card. Junk Giant. Ooh, nice. Dark Hole. Love that card. Downard Magician. Not a bad card either. And Exchange of the Spirits. This is a pretty evil card against decks that use low attack power monsters. Maybe not too sure about the, what they're called, Zodiacs nowadays, because some of them have low attack, the rest are still pretty decent, so it's too much for that card. But still, it could be a bitch to run into. Okay. Tristan, the guy that goes with the, Isolde we got last time. Cat Shark, nice, that's a pretty cool card. Starlight Road, not a bad. Exodia, the forbidden one again. Might as well sleeve him again. No, Starlight Road, not worth it. But still, not a bad pack either. So that was our first mini box. Didn't get that many awesome things, but we did get some pretty interesting cards. The Dark Hold and Charge were pretty nice. The Cat Shark is a pretty cool card to use for a level 2 decks. Like, let's say, the Frog decks or the Ojama decks. Such stuff like that. So it's pretty cool. Next box, the second from the front. And we have another Cat Shark. Cool. Cat Sharks. Number 95, Galaxy Eyes Dark Matter Dragon. It's not a bad card, but I don't think it's gotten much use. Gladiator Beast Gizaris, that's nice. Chain Disappearance again, and oh my god! Yes! Finally! I don't know how many of these mini boxes I bought in total through the years, and I finally get my first Ray Geki out of it. This is insane, guys. This is awesome, and it's only our fourth pack. Are we gonna get any other Ray Gekis? That is awesome, guys. The gold rare Ray Geki. It's a pretty nice holo. Like a pretty nice foil to get. I just love it already. And it's first edition, of course. Awesome. My third Ray Geki ever. In 15 years. Guys, it's like an average of one Ray Geki per 5 years. This is ridiculous. Rose Paladin. Tristan again. Enemy Controller. Not bad. That's one of the staples. Well, it's not as much of a staple nowadays as it used to be, but it's still pretty cool. Sylvan Charity. Glow Up Bulb. Nice. Wow, okay. So apparently the second box was the lucky one from this set. Might as well put Glow Up Bulb in one of these awesome sleeves because it's an awesome card to get. I don't know if it's still any interesting, if it's still interesting in the current meta. Don't think so, because plants aren't seeing as much love as they used to. But it is one hell of a good card. For those who are not familiar with it, although I'm pretty sure you would still be familiar with it, if this card is in the graveyard, you can send the top card of your deck to the graveyard. And if you do, special summon this card, and it's a level 1 tuner. But you can only use that effect once per duel. So it's a pretty, pretty good card. I mean, as soon as it hits the graveyard, you can use it. And you could already use it, you could already use him on the actual field. So that's like 2 synchros in 1 turn if you had the right stuff on your field. Back then, it was pretty awesome. And we have Isolde to put with the rest. Formula Synchron! What? 3 of the cards we were looking for. In the second box. This is intense. Intense, I'm telling you. Karma Cut also. Awesome. Second box is the best box I've gotten in years for this set. Might as well put Formula in one of these. Maybe not. I'm going to keep him in one of these other Warhammer sleeves instead. Because you'd never know what else you will find. Sleeving Karma Cut, which was one very good staple back in the days. And still a pretty nasty card nowadays. For those who don't know what Karma Cut does, because I know some of you might not, discard one card, then target one face-up monster your opponent control. Banish that target, then banish all cards with the same name as that monster from your opponent's graveyard. So, let's say your opponent spams a specific card, and there's already like two or three, like, out from the deck. You can banish all three of them, and that's going to hurt the opponent so much. Unless it's one of those banish decks, which just you won't care as much, but still. Ooh, first time I've seen this one. Parallel Twister. Send one other spell trap card you control to the graveyard, then target one card in the field, destroy it. Pretty nice. Worth a sleeve. Ooh, number 14, Greedy Sarameya. It's a rank 5, which is not a bad thing. Oh. That's nice. It's not a bad effect either. Cool. Doom Caliber Knight, Temple of the Kings, and hey, they're going together. That's nice to get them in the same pack. So, Doom Caliber Knight, that's pretty neat. Sleeving him up. Sleeving up this one, too. Second pack from the middle box. And we've got a Nothung. Blackwing Nothung the Starlight, I believe. Yep, Starlight. Pretty neat. Pretty neat. Wow, two Blackwing secrets in one pack. That's pretty awesome. That is pretty awesome. Veil of Darkness, compulsory, and Neo Alias. Nice. Pretty nice. Three cards worth sleeving in this one. That's pretty cool. Compulsory is a pretty decent staple from back in the days. Pinaki, the Waxing Moon, is a pretty awesome Blackwing tuner, and we've got one of the good Blackwing synchros now. Let's see what else this third box had in reserves for us. Oh, I like what I'm seeing. Santa Claus. Nice. Santa Claus. The stupidest pun, but it's one of the best. You can special summon this card from your hand to your opponent's side of the field in defense position by tributing one monster they control. If summoned this way during the end phase of this turn, you can draw one card. So basically, it's like one of those kaiju cards, except it's a little weaker, so you can more or less easily go over it. And it's not that good for your opponent either, and you can tribute anything, so it's not something easy to just like stop from happening. And it's a pretty awesome looking card. Let's be honest. Love that card. Ooh. Ghost Charon, the Underworld Boatman. Nice. A little zombie tuner for us. Ooh, Graffa Dragon Lord of Dark World. Hey, an Exodia piece. Nice. The left arm of Exodia. That's pretty cool. Well, of the forbidden one, but still. And a rank up Magic Baron's Force. That's neat. So that's a pretty cool box we got again. Not as good as this box, but still, pretty awesome box. Yeah, we're gonna go for the fourth meaty box. And we have another Nothung and another Exodia piece. That looks promising. Nothung, Cat Shark again. We've got the trio. Crush Card Virus. Pot of Duality. Nice. And, oh, another left arm. Okay, I'll take it. Not complaining on that one. Move these a little back. Okay. Pot of Duality is a pretty nice card to own, and it's a pretty nice rarity to have as gold. So that's pretty cool. Up to now, we've got our three of the most wanted cards from this set. We've got our trio of cat shards, which is nice. We got a couple of Exodia pieces, so that's not a bad thing either. Exodia's broken. Complete the puzzle to find out what will happen next. Still looking for that Solemn card. I wouldn't be against having another Dark Hole from this set. They are pretty neat. Isolde, Rose Paladin, Doom Calibur again. Rank up Magic Numeron Force, and ooh, nice! Trap Tricks, Trap Hole, Nightmare. Pretty happy to get this one as a foil. It's out as a common nowadays, so it's not worth much, but it's a pretty good card. When a monster that was special summoned this turn activates its effect on your opponent's side of the field, negate that effect, and if you do, destroy that card. So it's pretty good against decks like, let's say, the Zodiacs, because they are the main deck nowadays, except maybe for the ABCs that are still there, and Wind Witches, which I'm still working on. But let's say the opponent spams his Zodiacs, because whatever, they like to spam stuff. And then he decides to, he notices you don't negate his actual summons, so he knows you don't have a Solemn. So he's just gonna keep spamming again and again. And then when he uses his effect, thinking that you don't have anything good against it, bam! Trap Tricks, Trap Hole, Nightmare. Pretty cool. So our final pack from this mini box. A Ghost Charon again, another Anki. Ooh, nice! Naturia Beast. Lavalval Chain, awesome! Two great extra deck cards. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. And another Charge of the Light Brigade. Nice. I am not against this at all. This is a pretty cool set, guys. Naturia Beast. I got two of the gold rare Naturia Beasts, I believe, now. And I've got two of the secret rare from the original Idden Arsenal set. So, I think I'm all set with Naturia Beasts. And our last mini box, guys. These are the ones who ran away from us earlier and fell behind the desk. So let's see why they were running away. Do they contain anything valuable? Or just anything awesome, really? I would take anything. I already got my Raigeki. I wouldn't be against getting a second one or any of these two again. I wouldn't be against that. I still want a second Dark Hole. I wouldn't be against getting a Solemn Judgment. I actually want no, Solemn Warning, sorry. I would be very happy to get a one from this set. I believe there might be a Foolish Burial in this set and a Call of the Haunted too. Not too sure. Still more pieces of Exodia to be found. That would be nice. I think I'm missing one leg as a gold rare in total, since I've already got a few pieces from back in the days also. So yeah. A lot of interesting stuff still looking forward to. Hey, another Pero Pero. That's cool. Enemy controller. Awesome! Left leg! Left leg of the Forbidden One. I think that's the one I was missing. So that's pretty cool. Ask and you shall receive. And another Neo Alias. This has been going well. Come on, Solemns, or other very sought after cards. Two packs. Two more of these awesome sleeves. Don't disappoint me. You ran away from me. Give me something for it. Absolute King Backjack. Galaxy Eyes Dark Matter again. Five-headed dragon. That's nice. Solemn Warning. Ask and you shall receive. That mini box is the one where you ask anything and you get it. Pretty neat. And, ooh, Bujin Yamato. That's a pretty cool card. It used to be pretty good to run Bujins. Not sure nowadays, but this is worth sleeving. But Solemn Warning in the good sleeves, of course. Wow. I got the two cards I wanted the most out of this set. Got two of the other cards that I wanted also a lot. Wow. This has been going well. Pretty well. Okay, yeah, might as well sleeve him. I've got lots of these sleeves. And Five-Headed Dragon, of course, that's an awesome card. I don't think it's seeing as much use nowadays as it used to, but It is still an awesome card to get. But man, this is awesome. One last pack. Can we see a duplicate of one of these? Or maybe a duplicate of one of these two? Wouldn't be against that either. Can we see anything actually very interesting in here? Foolish Burial wouldn't be a bad card either. Many, many more interesting cards to get. And we have here. This name is way too shiny. Dragocytos, Corrupted Nether Soul Dragon. Damn, that's a shiny card. Parallel Twister again, that's cool. Gores, nice. Rank up and Card Trooper. Oh well, it's still not a bad pack to finish off. It is not a bad pack to finish off with. Gores was a pretty awesome card back in the days. Still, nowadays might still be useful because a lot of cards are pretty decent at inflicting damage. So yeah, that's pretty cool. Card Trooper is pretty neat. Also, in Parallel Twister, well, it's just an awesome card to get from this set. I don't even know if it's been printed in any other set. Send one other spell trap card you control to the graveyard and target one card in the field and destroy it. I know I read it earlier too, but it's still a pretty cool card. Well, we still had one of these. Guess that was meant for this guy. Might as well switch him out. He was one of the best cards we got. Might as well treat him nicely. So, a quick recap of the interesting cards we got. We got a couple of these. We got a couple of these. So, that's pretty nice. We got Gores, Card Trooper, Perro-Perro, Five-Headed Dragon, Bujin Yamato, Enemy Controller, Lavalval Chain, Naturia Beast, Trap Tricks, Trap Hole Nightmare. As I said, a couple of these. Doom Caliber, Nothung. I think we got twice also. Pot of Duality, Santa Claus, Pinaki, the Waxing Moon. Yep, second one. Compulsory Evacuation Device. Second one again. Second one of these also. Karma Cut, Enemy Controller. I think it's our second two. And Dark Hole. So these were our interesting ones from this set. We got three Cat Sharks. It's just an awesome card to get. You just gotta love that awesome finish it's got. Even its eyes are shining. Pretty cool. We got three different pieces of the Exodia. Three different pieces of Exodia. That's pretty neat. Two left arms, one left leg. So I guess this box was for left people. And we got one head. We got Formula Synchron, Glow Up Bulb, and Solemn Warning and Raigeki. Awesome cards to get from this set. From the last little box, we got these other cards. Not bad. From the second to last, we got these cards also. From the middle box, we had all these, which are also pretty interesting cards. Even if they're not sleeved, it doesn't mean they're not good cards. From the second box of the set, we got these. And from the first one we opened, we got all of these. So, yeah. Pretty decent opening. Happy to have been on YouTube for at least a month right now. I promise you some more good content in the future. And keep watching. Like, subscribe if you want. I'm not gonna force you. I mean, who am I to do that, right? Comment if you have any suggestions for future videos or if you want any answers or anything about cards that I get or if you want to talk strategy. I mean, you can PM me if you want. I can do many, many things related to hobbies. I've got many different hobbies too. Since it's only been 1 month, I've only focused on Yu-Gi-Oh!, but I can also do videos about other things. So yeah, thanks for watching. Panem out.